Hi guys, so welcome back to another episode of Just Fishing. Today we are at Punggol Waterfront. You can see the barrels behind me. Yep, so the time now is 2:30. Yeah, 2:30-ish. Okay, so we'll be fishing here until about 6 plus 7. We'll see how things go again. We are fishing a rising tide. Yeah, the rising tide. And the bait for today will be live prawn and violet worm. Yep. So we'll see how things go, start fishing and update you guys later.
I think this is a Minky Rong or Crescent Perch. Are you coming here?
Crescent Perch on.
So this one really need to be careful because there are spikes everywhere on this fish, you can see. The behind, everywhere got spikes here. So best is to wear a glove, but I don't have a glove, so too bad. Many of the comments about rig tying and what rigs do we use. So now we'll do a rig tying video. So we just basically show you the basic rig that we'll use for most of our sessions. Okay, the size of the hook for now is size 1. Okay, size 1. Can see? Size 1. So 2 size 1. Okay, we use a double Apollo. Okay, so this will be my 2 hooks. And this is just basic Dupont 30 pound leader. Yeah, 30 pound leader. And
yeah.
Okay, 30 pound leader. Okay, so usually the way I tie rig is that I will leave the leader attached to the rope and then I'll tie. Okay, but because of my injury down here, I cannot grip as tightly as I once could. So the way I'll tie it now is separate, means I'll cut off a leg of leader first. Okay, so how much leader you need will depend on what kind of rig you are trying to make. So double Apollo for size 1 30 pound leader will usually need about an arm's length plus a little bit. About 1 arm's length plus a little bit hanging out here. yeah, until here. Okay, so if you are scared that you will run out of leader, you can just pull a little bit more and then you just cut inside. And then you just pull it up. Okay, so now here is your leader. There is the tie the rig. And yeah. So we start our rig with a loop knot. Okay, I don't really know what knot this is called. Okay, but it's quite a basic knot. Basically, you double back the leader, you pinch it together, and then you make a loop. Put through one time, put through second time, then you just pull. Okay, because my finger got no strength, I will use my teeth to bite. Okay, so this is your loop knot. Your loop knot basically forms a loop for you. So this part will be the one that goes into your swivel. Okay, so the excess you can just cut it away. Please dispose of it properly. Okay. Now we will tie our first hook. Okay, so this is called a snell knot. Okay, there are many ways to snell a hook. Okay, this is just one of the ways. I know there are many other ways. Okay, but this is called an immovable snell. Means the once I snell it on the hook, cannot turn any direction. Okay, some snell knot, but after you snell the hook, still can turn. Mine cannot. So first what you do is put the leader through the eyelet of the hook and then you hold it like this. Leader goes up, goes one round, chuck together.
You repeat.
The leader, okay, leader put through like that. Chuck this, pull, go one round. So basically your leader goes like that. Then you see this loop, you see this line. Okay. This loop must go around the hook and the line one time. Around the hook and the line two times. Around the hook and the line three times. Okay. Three times is the minimum you should do. Okay, but since I got a lot, I will just keep doing. So the more rounds you go, obviously the more secure it will be. Okay, so after I've run out of loop, I will pull this one to tighten the whole thing. And again, because my finger got no strength, I will use my teeth to bite. Okay, so here you have your snell. Okay, a correct, proper snell will have all the loops in one nice straight line. And then the top loop will come down around the whole stem and then come out here. And you have one thing coming out.
Can you show it in there?
After that, this one, cut away. Okay, next. Now that you have a hook on one end, okay, and then you have a loop on the other end, you want to make a snood. Okay, so in order to make a snood, you need to bring the hook up to about this point. The loop, the knot of the loop. Grab it like that. Okay, so this is how you decide how long the snood, the length of your snood will be. So the longer you tie it, if you tie it down here, your snood will be very long. If you tie it down here, it will be very short. So usually I will do it one palm length plus a little bit. So I'll tie it somewhere. So how to tie? This is another loop knot. Okay, it's very similar to the first one. Basically, you make a loop. Pinch it with your thumb and index finger. The remaining long stretch of line, you put it through once, put it through twice, put it through three times. So remember the first knot, you put it through twice. This one you must put it through three times. Okay. Then after you just pull it to tighten. Again, because I have an injury, I cannot tighten properly. I will use the loop to help me. One time here, and then I will tighten another time using a pair of scissors. Hook onto the hook. And pull. Okay. Please don't pull until your hook straighten out. okay, because some of the hooks are not that well made, so they might straighten out.
And careful, don't hook yourself.
Yeah, and of course don't hook yourself when doing this. Okay. So here you have one snood. Yeah. So this one is step one. Okay. Next, you can cut either of these lines, okay? Either one, it doesn't matter which one you cut, the result will be the same. So let's say maybe I want to cut this one. Now we will snell on our second hook. So here, same like usual, put it through the eye hole. Choose how long you want your snood to be. Make a loop. Go through one time, two time, three time. Tighten. Again, it doesn't matter which one you cut. You can cut either one. Okay, finally will be the loop for your sinker to put through. Okay, so this loop is the loop knot, exactly the same as the first knot you tied for the swivel. So we double back, make a loop, go through one time, go through two times, and just pull. Okay, finish. This one can cut away. Okay. So here it is, a full double Apollo rig like that. Okay, usually for me I tie the top snood shorter than the bottom snood longer la. Okay, but this is up to personal preference. You all can adjust over it. You can tie the same length, you can tie both very long, you can tie both very short, up to you. Yeah, so it's just personal preference la. But this is basically how you tie double Apollo that we use for almost all of our sessions. Okay, so to keep this, from this you want to keep into something like that, so that it's much easier to keep lah. The hook don't swing everywhere. Okay. You take the end, the sinker, the knot, and then you just wrap. Okay. Then you realize you have two hooks. So you take these two hooks, you pull it through again. Yeah. Pull it through again. And then when you reach the end, right, put this hook into the coil. So this one still got a bit, you can go one more round, and then put it into the coil. So that way the hook will be inside. So that is how you coil up your double Apollo or any other rig. Okay. Right, so that's it for knot tying. Okay, the basic knots you will need is just to tie a loop and to snell the hook. So it's very simple, very basic. Okay, once you have those two knots, you can tie almost any rig you want to tie. Okay, plus minus a few other knots. Okay, but these are the most basic knots that you will use when fishing up, and these are the rigs that we usually use for most of our sessions. Alright, so yeah, that's about it for this video lah.